Been selling a house recently, running my open home. A family comes along, they look around, they come to me, we have a chat about the house, and then they ask, Andrei, where is the downstairs? I say, well, there is no downstairs. There is three bedrooms here. There is a modern bathroom and kitchen, but there is no downstairs. Why are you asking? Andrei, we expected a bigger house for that price. Let's talk about pricing. Okay, so this is our price from down up, and let's say we have a two window house for sale. Two window meaning that it possesses certain features, right? So we have a two window house, right? And right now two window houses, they sell for say 900,000, right? And this is the fair market price range. Okay, and then we've got say bigger houses which are three window houses, they possess better features, and right now they sell for 950, for example. And then this is our even bigger four window house, and right now they say, let's say they sell for $1 million. Every now and then we have an optimistic vendor, and they say, okay, for my two window house I want the four window house price. And here goes our two window house competing with four window houses. I would like you to think about those price ranges as shopping aisles. You know, when you come to the supermarket, you go through the aisles and you expect certain products, certain goods in each of the aisles, right? So when we display our two window house in this four window house aisle, then what happens? These people who shop for a four-window house, obviously they have a bit more money, and they expect a certain house in that aisle. When they look a smaller house or, you know, inferior house, they pick it up from the shelf, they look at it and they say, okay, and they put it back on the shelf. So what happens in this scenario? We won't have any visitors to our open homes. They will be very boring open homes. You might get a neighbor come in for a quick look, or somebody driving by seeing the flag coming in, but generally buyers, they don't come to open homes for houses which are overpriced, right? And what happens here, some vendors, they get stuck on it. They say, we do want, you know, a four window house price for our two window house, and then they wait and they wait, only nothing happens, there is no offers, and they sometimes decide to try by negotiation. They hide the price, they say, okay, let's try negotiation, and then they expect the agent to be able to explain why this two window house has to sell for the price of a four window house, which is usually very difficult. And then these vendors, they would wait and wait and wait. They would be unhappy with the agent, thinking he or she is not good enough. Then they probably switch to another agency after the agreement expires with the first agency. And it's a very sad and unhappy experience for everyone. You see, those people who shop in this aisle, they do have a bit more money. And that's probably because they made wise decisions with their money before, so there is no chance they would pay a four window house price for a two window house, right? So some vendors, they would be more reasonable and they would say, okay, we tried at this level, let's adjust the price. And here goes our two window house competing with three window houses in that three window aisle, right? And what happens here? You will start getting open home visitors. People will start coming to have a look and see, why is it two bedroom, two window house competing? It is in the aisle for three window houses. Let's have a look. So some people will come, and what will be happening there? They will be commenting, they will be complaining, they would say something is wrong. There is always the kitchen is not right, you know, the bathroom is old, or the garage is not large enough, or there is not enough storage, or the driveway is too long, or something. Why are they complaining negatively? It is because they're comparing this two-window house with other houses in this aisle, which are three-window houses, which are better houses, right? So in this situation, people comment negatively, and they won't make offers again. Again, those people, they have enough money to buy a three-window house, and they won't compromise for a two-window one. So lots of negative feedback. And then if the vendor is wise enough, they adjust the price. And once the house is in the right aisle, all of a sudden you start getting the right buyers coming to the open homes. So you have more people come to open homes, and they don't comment negatively anymore. You know, all of a sudden the kitchen becomes right, and the driveway is not too long, and everything else is right. And this is where you, as a vendor, you will start getting offers. And the skill of the agent, of course, is to present the house well so that the house sells at the top of the price range. Okay, this is a very simplified way of explaining the pricing strategy and the feedback that the vendors would get from the buyers when they position their house in the wrong aisles, so to speak. And going back to where is the downstairs situation, this is obviously we were somewhere here overpriced, and the buyers came expecting a bigger house. I hope the simplified version of price strategy is still helpful. If you have any questions, let us know. If you're thinking of buying or selling, we would be very keen to help you. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.